Thinking about Dave, my teacher. He's the guy, he's the only American writer for the board game Trivial Pursuit, and he's one of three inventors of the game. But he's also been my guitar teacher for over 20 years, and I met him at the University of Alabama, and a spot opened up in his very busy schedule, because he's a real master, because he had pulled an ice pick out on a student and started apparently jabbing at his right hand during, you know, a sore study, and the guy quit, which tells you something about, you know, me, that I, took the spot immediately as soon as it opened up. So we were quite a pair, and Dave nicknamed all of his students. He liked to nickname them so he could remember, you know, this sense of individuality, who was who, and because I wanted to learn so many different styles of play, he decided to nickname me in the fashion of the old blues player Blind Lemon Jefferson, which, according to Dave, was to be nicknamed after an affliction and a fruit and a president's last name. So instead of Blind Lemon Jefferson, my nickname for that semester was Leper Banana Nixon. But the very first lesson we did, I don't know if he was trying to get rid of me or if he knew he had a star pupil, because we spent half an hour on this one note, which is an F sharp, although with the capo on it's like an L or something. Is that right, Pat? So we worked on vibrato, and, you know, so he wanted to talk about how you use vibrato to enter a piece, or, you know, phrasing, or I wasn't sure what, but, you know, I was 18, I wasn't going to argue with him, plus he pulled an ice pick out on a guy. By the way, I asked him years later why he did that, and I'll never forget his response. He went, "Oh yeah, that guy, but you should have seen how high he was keeping his thumb." So I played my vibrato note, and I went, and Dave went, "Nope." "Oh, I forgot to breathe." So I went, and Dave went, "Nope." And I said, "Oh, maybe he's looking for some rest stroke. I know rest stroke." So I went, Dave went, "Nope." thought, oh, he wants me to play the note and hesitate before the vibrato. And I went, and he went, nope. And then I went, and immediately he went, yeah, that was it. I did that again, and I went, and he went, nope. Half an hour of that. I mean, I see his point now, but at the time I had trouble paying him for that lesson. But sort of like the time we spent a whole lesson working on facial dynamics because he had taped a TV show I did. Pointed out to me, the way he put it, I was making a face like a cat in a litter box. So we spent half an hour just, you know, practicing. Twitches in there somewhere. He said I became the only student he's ever had who could smile during the entire piece if it was in a minor key. I don't know how I could do that, but I just do. I practiced a lot. I went back to my dorm room and I sit there on the edge of the bed, you know, just looking in the mirror. And I had a roommate, and he was gone a lot once I started doing that, so it was kind of a nice way to get the place to yourself.